I am happy to attend this conference and congratulate you for having chosen such an important topic for discussion. After independence, we had promised in the Constitution to strengthen the third level of our democracy. The first and the second levels, which are governed from Delhi and the state capitals, have been strengthened following several elections, and no one can weaken them. The third level is weak and it affects the first two levels also, because people at the top level have become paper tigers and the structure has become weak. This has to be set right by strengthening the Panchayati Raj institution. To reinforce our democracy, it is essential to strengthen the democratic institutions at the lowest level. To gear up the development process, it is necessary to revitalize these institutions at the district, block and village levels. In the last 2 years, we have done many things in this context. We began with organizing discussions at various levels. Now we have come to you after doing our homework. I hope we will be able to help you and fulfill the promises we had made. Promises were made during the freedom struggle and in our constitution, but no one effectively implemented them. The people at the top level were busy strengthening their own positions in politics as well as in administration and completely neglected the federal institutions. Whenever elections to the panchayats were held, they remained nominal. And for the last 20 years, mostly nominated members are running these institutions. This cannot strengthen the base level. As promised, the transfer of power to the grassroots level could not be effected, and whatever was done was generally in an arbitrary manner. In some states where transfer of power had been implemented, a member was nominated to the local bodies by the administration. The decision-making authority remained either with the state governments or with the administration, and it could not come down to the base level. In addition, sufficient resources were not made available for the betterment of the rural people, and the meager amount provided was not spent according to the needs of the rural people. In our development planning, the participation of the local bodies was lacking. We have to change this situation. The result was that the power did not actually reach them. It meant that the plans and the schemes made could not in reality cater to your needs. The development programs which were worked out could neither improve your conditions nor remove your difficulties. The result was that even after the completion of those schemes, their full benefit could not reach you. Whatever economic development was achieved could not be effective because there was a vast gap between the preparation of the schemes and their implementation. The result was that even for the solution of minor issues, the people looked to the government. Those issues which can be tackled at the village level should be dealt with there. If the central government is involved in such issues, what requires to be done can neither be done well nor in time. You know, there are many procedural requirements in the implementation of a project which involves many people, and these will only create problems. We must ensure that our people are not totally dependent on the government for all types of development works. They should themselves have a feeling of participation in development programs and the process of a social change. This will require that the gap between the administration and the people be filled. We have to see that the people, whether they are in politics or government, do not rush to district or state capital for the redressal of every grievance. If development work can be planned for at the district, block or village level, it should be taken up there itself. If this is not done, schemes will be delayed and so will their implementation. I have great pleasure in extending my greetings and good wishes for the success of your deliberations. When I meet you again on the last day of the conference, I hope to get from you good and solid answers to the question which I have posed before you. Dear sir, we are in receipt of your esteemed letter of 6th instant pointing out the inordinate delay in complying with your order for the supply of special variety of plastic coated cards. We are extremely sorry for the inconvenience that we would have been caused to you. I may bring to your kind notice that due to the recent flash floods, our factory and the godowns were submerged with water and the stocks kept in our godowns were under 2 feet of water for a week. Unfortunately, most of our stocks were damaged and we have to indent for fresh stocks from our sister company at Bombay. In fact, we are making every effort to supply the goods to you as early as possible. I am happy to inform you that we have received a reply today informing us that the plastic cards indented by us were dispatched yesterday and they are likely to take 4 or 5 days to reach us. We earnestly hope that we will be in a position to execute your order in the next few days. I am quite sure you will appreciate our difficulties explained above and bear with us. In the meantime, to avoid any further delay and inconvenience to you, we would suggest for your consideration whether you would like to accept our other variety of cards at a slightly higher rates. Though it would be a loss to us if we agree to supply this variety of special cards, still, due to our delay, we would like to offer the benefit of special concession and supply them at the same rates. If you are prepared to agree with our suggestion, we shall arrange to deliver them in the next few days. I shall be grateful for a line in confirmation. Yours faithfully.